Sanford Biggers is an artist who mixes media and who pushes boundaries to create an art all his own. Jeffrey Brown looks at his interdisciplinary work, focusing on a signature work, Fool's Folly, for our arts and culture series, Canvas.
On the walls, 20th century quilts that have become recognized as masterly works of art. On the floor, a new work using similar patterns but a different art form, a Buddhist sand mandala.
It's literally made out of sand.
It's right? Colored sand, yeah. Unaffixed, placed on the floor. Yeah. We sneeze right now, this thing is gone.
There's no sneezing, but plenty of riffing in Sanford Biggers' work, now on exhibition at Washington, D.C.'s Phillips Collection. For an ongoing project the museum calls Intersections, he's created a sculpture that plays off others already in the museum's collection by artists such as Picasso and Giacometti. But his marble bust is a hybrid figure. From the back, a classical Greek image of a woman. From the front, an ancestral African chokwe mask.
What I'm doing is putting those two together to create some type of conceptual dialogue. So I'm looking at this as the ancestors, basically, of modern aesthetics. And we say the classical form and then the non-classical form, but I think we're past that. I would consider that a classical European form and a classical African form.
And what is it now? When you
now
put them together.
Now it's contemporary art.
He polishes his suit and tie.
Biggers, now 51, finds and creates his art in many places, including with his experimental band, Moon Medicine. As much art happening as musical performance. And he uses the language of contemporary music, like sampling and hip-hop, to describe his own approach to art making from different traditions. What he calls material storytelling.
So how do you sample it, change it, distort it, put it back together, paste it with something else to create a new body of work? I think objects are evocative. I think the object elicits certain memories and certain narratives. And when they're juxtaposed with other objects, it creates more complicated narratives.
He did it in a large-scale public way earlier this year with a series at New York's Rockefeller Center. Another remix using classical sculptures, which were themselves originally brightly painted. And he does it in a more intimate way through his interest in textiles, especially antique quilts. A traveling exhibition titled Code Switch is currently at the California African American Museum in Los Angeles.
I started to paint and draw and intervene on these antique quilts and started to consider it a sort of transgenerational, cross-generational communications.
It began with a theory that quilts had been used as signposts along the Underground Railroad to give coded instructions to escaping enslaved people. The theory was never conclusively proven, but Biggers loved the idea behind it.
I thought, okay, what if these held codes? What would it mean for me then to come in 100 years or however many years later and add another layer of code to them? So in this sense, I am a late collaborator with the original makers of the quilt.
When it comes to the now famous quilts of G's Bend, there's no painting on or reworking allowed. So the collaboration is of a different kind.
You have to have a mind made up the piece of queer.
That's true.
Because if you don't have a mind made up the piece that queer, it ain't gonna never go right.
In 2003, I had a chance to visit the small, isolated Alabama community of G's Bend, where several generations of women created quilts of extraordinary designs, shapes, and colors, piecing together irregular strips of fabric. The quilts drew comparison to modernist abstract paintings and were exhibited at New York's Whitney Museum and around the country. One person who saw the quilts on exhibition back then was Sanford Biggers. Now, the Phillips Collection, which owns 5 G's Bend quilts, wanted Biggers to explore and address them through his own work.
First thing I see is rhythm.
The movement through color and...
A retinal type of pacing that happens when you look at them. Which are, you know, one of the hallmarks of a well-composed painting, mm-hmm. is how the eye can move and dance around it, mm-hmm. and these do that immediately.
Biggers constructed a three-dimensional quilt sculpture, and having studied Buddhist culture in Japan, decided to find his rhythm in a mandala sand quilt painting. He was helped by museum assistants trained in this unusual installation. Add it all up, and it's an endless kind of play. Especially when you have all of art history to play with.
I think that's, once again, what artists do. The trick is to find your voice within that, within the realm of possibilities. How do you find a voice, and what are you saying with that voice?
And have you found it?
I have multiple voices. I have a chorus.
Sanford Biggers' Code Switch exhibition is in Los Angeles until January 23rd, before moving to the Speed Museum in Louisville beginning mid-March. His Washington, D.C. work is on display through January 9th. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown at the Phillips Collection.